When we sit around the filling station, we like to kick tires and tell stories. And here's the most bodacious storyteller of them all, C.W. McCall.
One day, about 4 or 5 years ago, we were sitting at the Conoco station, kicking tires and swatting flies and discussing the State of the Union. When right out in front of the Baptist church come a big old purple school bus. Had astrological signs upon it and 35 hippies and dogs inside. About half of them went for the courthouse lawn and them dogs commenced on the fire plug. The rest of them sat there staring at us and I says, Roy, go get your flip gun. He says, which is the hippies and which is the dogs? I says, beats the heck out of me, Roy. What there was a bunch of them crispy critters and the leader was a space cadet. And he says,
Sagittarius, we have arrived. Prepare to disembark, man. Get the incense going in the sitar. Are we going to camp in the city park, man?
I says, boys, let me explain the situation to you. A, you're getting me down. And B, we got us a leash law here. And C, you in the wrong town. You drop one string of beads in that there park, and you're going to see a whole lot of stars. You got 15 seconds to get out of town, boys, or we going to blow you to Mars. Well, they all got back in the purple bus and proceeded to the city limits. Then the telephone rang. It was a swimming pool. It says a mess of wild critters was in it. So we all got to Marshall's Plymouth, which is always at the Conoco station. Went flashing on down to the swimming pool to give them critters a citation. By the time we arrived, it was just too late. Them critters had all had their pants down. Them dogs was tearing the bathhouse apart, and they's after the fish in the fish pond. I says, Roy, you get the one to sell for T-shirt, and I'll get the rest with a net. We going to have a jail full of naked crispy critters and a drip-dried space cadet. We lost the war because them critters outnumbered us. So they moved in and set up camp and they lived in that purple school bus. 6 weeks later, there was nothing in town but 84 dogs in the head shop selling dried up weeds and sunflower seeds and astrological postcards. Yeah, critters took over the city council and the dogs all barked their brains out. And the entire town was crispy critters and the mayor was a space cadet. Hee-haw salutes my hometown, Audubon, Iowa. Population 2,907. Come on, come on.
Oh, hi, truck person. What'll it be?
Well, lady, you can give me about 20 gallons of coffee to go.
20 gallons?
That's right. I'm C.W. McCall, and I got me a little pair of convoy sitting right outside.
You know who that is?
Whoa.
That is the rubber duck himself, honey. That's C.W. McCall.
You're C.W. McCall?
Golly.
Roger.
Oh, you mean you're Roger McCall.
Oh, no, fly brain. Roger means okay in C.B. talk.
Oh, yeah. And you're okay, McCall.
No, his name is C.W. McCall.
Well, what? How come you didn't introduce him the way you did and he come in here? Why can't you just do it like everybody else does?
No, now.
You shake hands with me and tell him my name.
Look at all that. He told me that his name was C.W.
I know, and I said Roger McCall, and you said that. You said his whole name was taller than he did. Now, what do you think up your mind once in a while? No wonder nobody comes in here.
Golly, won't you ask him?
Is your... Oh, no. He's gone. I didn't even get his autograph.
Neither did I.
Oh,
what am I going to do?